Margaret Walsh, 1892 to 1975. You lived a good long life, Margaret, and I hope it was a happy life. I hope it was a good life, and I hope you did not fear your death. Thank you for allowing me today to come and clean your headstone so that your name can shine. Because even in death, we should always shine. I've had my eye on your headstone for a couple of weeks now, and I just keep getting sidetracked. With other headstones, but no more. Today's Friday. It's gonna be a good day. And I'm looking forward. To having a good day. It has been a long week for me. Very long week. Lots of drama, and I don't do well with drama. My husband has gone up to North Carolina. His dad is not well after having heart surgery. My oldest daughter is giving me a hard time. And my youngest daughter is giving me a hard time with life. They're not bad girls. They're just, I suppose, testing my limits. And I don't like having my limits tested in such ways. Margaret. My grandmother's name is Margaret. So whenever I hear the word Margaret, I just always think of a really good person. And I have a feeling you are a very good person too, Margaret. I just feel it. It's gonna be beautiful here in Central Florida today. Spring is definitely in the air, and I am ready for this drama to end. Margaret, while I'm here, I'm all ears. If you have anything you want to share with me, I am listening. Margaret Walsh. I hear you saying dove, doves. Okay. You had doves, and I don't think they were real, but you keep saying that right now. Doves. I have a set of doves and my Nana and Papa. Very special. On my fireplace mantle. A beautiful headstone. So, what happened this morning is I dropped my daughter off at school, which is right across the street from here. About 10 minutes from our home. And once I dropped my daughter off, I was about a quarter of the way home and I got a text message from her that her shoes broke. Yes, her shoes broke. And this is during COVID, where we're not allowed to drop off homework assignments forgotten or lunches forgotten or shoes. So I had to go through a whole slew of making sure when I got there with the shoes, I'd be allowed to leave them. And it's not that it's a big deal, that's part of my job as a mother, to be the one to bring forgotten shoes to school. It just seems like it's always something. These days, always something. I'm like, I've never been so on edge in my life. And Margaret, I feel that from you too. You're rather anxious. Okay, the back of your headstone is gonna be a task in itself. That's gonna be a big job. But that's what I'm here for, Margaret. No task is too big for me. Margaret, I feel like you had one child, and I'm hearing the name Sarah. Maybe she wasn't your child, I don't know, but she was definitely a child figure. Sarah. My friend, Cemetery Girl Number One, Ingrid, gifted to me, a very special book on Oviedo history and all of the people buried here. And so every time I clean a headstone, I like to go home and look and see if that person is in the book. To see if what I feel while I'm cleaning their headstones is accurate. Well, Margaret, the very act of me doing this provides me great peace. So, thank you, Margaret. What the heck was that? Was that a fox? It's a hawk. like we have a visitor here. Let's try this. That is a beautiful hawk standing over there. Oh, it's coming closer. That's a big hawk, too. Margaret, can we call the hawk over here? Well, this is turning out lovely. Just in time for the weekend, huh? That hawk is literally just standing there staring at us. Okay, he just flew onto a branch, even closer to us. This is something. I wonder if it's because I'm not paying attention to the hawk. Almost done. Just need to get a little bit more water. BRB. You have just made me happy. today, Margaret, because it does make me happy to clean headstones. I still think it would be a wonderful idea for schools to have cemetery headstone cleanings as part of history class. And you're assigned so many stones to clean, and after you clean them, you research the people. Because I know I was never interested in history in school, but I find this fascinating. All right, Margaret, let me get your flowers. You seem like a light purple. I think that would make you happy. Margaret, thank you for your life. I do hope you're resting in peace.